Here are a few remarkable findings that have been made during cave diving expeditions, ranging from the enigmatic Baltic Anomaly to the uncovering of previously lost American fighter planes from World War II. The mysterious Baltic Anomaly, a UFO or a geological object. In 2015, Swedish oceanographers Peter Lindberg and Dennis Asberg discovered a peculiar object in the Baltic Sea. The object, which was detected by sonar, had an irregular shape and was almost 200 feet long, lying at a depth of 279 feet. The object looked like the Millennium Falcon spaceship from the Star Wars movie, which sparked interest in the scientific community. Several explanations were offered by the discoverers, including the possibility of it being a geological object, a secret Third Reich project, or even an alien object. Scuba divers made attempts to explore the object, but every expedition had equipment failures when they got within 656 feet of it, and it would start working again as soon as they backed away. The material of the object turned out to be a piece of basalt with traces of burnt organics, indicating exposure to high temperatures, possibly from passing through the atmosphere. This material is more likely to be found in construction or a shipwreck rather than a geological process, according to experts. However, some scientists remain skeptical, including Volker Bruchert, a professor of geology at the University of Stockholm, who believes the find to be a trace of ancient glacier activity. The project was suspended due to a lack of funding, which has led to speculation that the world government may have an interest in the object and is keeping it hidden from the public. The truth behind the Baltic Anomaly remains a mystery, and it is uncertain whether it is a UFO or a geological object. Discovery of Yonaguni Monument. In 1985, a team of scuba divers led by Kihachiro Arataki, a diving instructor, made an incredible discovery near the southern border of an island. They found a megalith, consisting of ancient formations of regular shapes that resembled an ancient city. According to a study of the soil in the area, the megalith could be more than 20 million years old and had features reminiscent of ancient cultures from around the world. The central structure looked like a stepped pyramid of Maya or ancient Sumer, and there was a unique stone formation nearby that was 140 feet high. The megalith contained complex elements, including stairs, walls, and straight lines around the perimeter, as well as numerous pyramids that were 33 feet in height and 6.6 feet in width. The discovery was named after its place of discovery, the Yonaguni Monument. This discovery caused a stir in the scientific community, with experts taking opposing views about whether the monument was man-made or a geological formation. In 1992, Professor Masaki Kimura and his team from the University of Okinawa conducted extensive research after many years of diving activity in the area. They discovered carvings of plants, animals, and even people, as well as remnants of an infrastructure such as wells and mines within the megalith. Based on this evidence, Professor Kimura declared that the mysterious underwater object was human-made, indicating that the civilization that dwelled there was highly developed. However, the question remains as to how such a developed settlement appeared among 20-million-year-old strata, leading to the possibility that it was an alien outpost that was submerged. Ancient Mayan treasure and the discovery of the world's largest underwater cave. The Mayan civilization is known for its impressive advancements, yet their disappearance without a trace remains a mystery. In 2018, a team of divers explored an underwater key in the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico, uncovering relics from the Mayan era. However, the expedition led to a far greater discovery, the largest underwater cave in the world, spanning 216 miles. This cave, which represents the most significant submerged archaeological site globally, offers evidence of the first settlers of America, extinct fauna, and Mayan culture. The find is more than just a collection of artifacts, but a vast system of exploration, holding many secrets and revelations for those who delve into it. discover Priceless collection of gold coins. A group of scuba divers decided to explore the waters of Caesarea National Park, Israel, and found a surprising discovery, a gold coin, which they initially thought was a child's toy. As they continued to explore, they found more and more gold coins, eventually totaling over 200. The coins had engravings on them, indicating that they were official and real. Upon realizing the significance of their find, the divers sought permission from the Israeli Antiquities Authority to continue their search. What they found was not a singular treasure, but a diverse collection of coins from different periods and denominations. The origin of the coins and how they came to be in the waters of Caesarea National Park remains a mystery. Due to their historical value and uniqueness, it is impossible to place a monetary value on the collection. As a result, those involved simply label it as priceless. The sinking of the Spanish treasure fleet in 1715 and the hunt for its lost treasure. In 1712, Spain, having won a war for their succession from Britain and France, needed to replenish their reserves. They knew of treasure in Cuba and thus sent a fleet of ships to acquire it and bring it back to Spain. Fast forward to 1715, the fleet of 11 ships, laden with wealth such as gold, silver, and pearls, met with tragedy when they were caught in a hurricane while passing through Florida during hurricane season. The entire fleet sank, costing many their lives and leaving the treasure at the bottom of the sea. Despite this loss, occasional pieces of gold, silver, pearls, and other items from the treasure fleet wash up on the shores of the treasure coast. Over the years, divers have attempted to locate and retrieve some of the treasure from the sunken ships. While they have had some success, four of the ships, including the San Miguel with around $2 billion worth of precious items, remain undiscovered. The hunt for the lost treasure continues. Underwater river. If we were to choose one remarkable sight out of all, an underwater river would be it. Although divers are aware of the unusual things they may encounter below the water's surface, discovering an underwater river was unexpected. However, thanks to divers' exploration of the sinkholes of the Yucatan Peninsula, we now know that these rivers do exist. The sinkholes are filled with treasures, including Mayan artifacts and incredible caves. Nonetheless, the most astonishing discovery was made in the Cenote Angelita sinkhole, where an eerie underwater river was found just 100 feet below. The formation of the river is believed to be due to different water densities, with freshwater on the top layer and hydrogen sulfide on the bottom layer. When the two layers meet, a cloudy phenomenon resembling fog is created, giving the river a magical appearance. This discovery challenges our understanding of how ecosystems operate. Giant anacondas in the crystal clear waters of Brazil's Mo River. Some people dive in the hopes of discovering archaeological treasures, while others seek the adrenaline rush of diving with sharks. Professional diver and underwater videographer Bartolomeo Bove falls into the latter category. However, even for Bove, coming face to face with the largest snake in the world was a unique and thrilling experience. It turns out that there is a specific place in Brazil's Mo River where people can swim with anacondas. Despite the fact that anacondas typically prefer murky waters, they thrive in the crystal clear waters of this river, making it the perfect location to photograph these magnificent creatures. Bove and his partner were fortunate enough to encounter a stunning 23-foot-long, nearly 200-pound female anaconda. The female was friendly and curious, inspecting their camera before swimming away. Bove was left speechless by the encounter, unable to fully describe the sensations he experienced. Massive jellyfish discovered during deep dive in the UK. During a deep sea diving expedition, two divers, Dan Abbott and Lizzie Daly, stumbled upon the largest jellyfish ever captured on camera in the UK. The divers were documenting marine life for a week and were expecting to film blue sharks when they encountered this gentle giant. The jellyfish can grow up to 35 kilograms and have bells measuring almost 1 meter in diameter. Miss Daly initially mistook the jellyfish for kelp, but upon closer inspection, she realized the true enormity of the creature. Despite its size, the giant jellyfish is not considered to be dangerous and has only a mild sting. The encounter proved to be an incredible and humbling experience for the divers. Exploring the wonders of the Orta Cave. Many divers consider exploring the Orta Cave as one of their favorite activities. This breathtaking cave, located deep in the bedrock beneath the Ural Mountains in Russia, captures the attention of divers due to its endless beauty and unique characteristics. The Orta Cave is one of the longest underwater caves ever discovered, and it provides hours of exploration. The visibility in the cave is among the most pristine on the planet, comparable to the sinkholes of the Yucatan Peninsula. Despite the clarity of the water, divers do not encounter any iconic creatures during their exploration. The gypsum rock, which filters the water, is believed to be responsible for the clarity of the water. However, the water is extremely cold at only 4 degrees Celsius, making it suitable for dry suit diving only. Discovery of former American fighter planes lost in Watu. A team of researchers has made a surprising discovery of former American fighter planes that were lost in the Chuuk Lagoon during World War II. The discovery, made 76 years after the Operation Hailstone and assault of the Allied forces on a Japanese naval base, has shed new light on historical events and their underwater significance. The project recovered 2 dive bombers and 1 Avenger at the Chuuk Lagoon in the state of Micronesia, alongside over 50 Japanese ships and 230 aircraft, 30 of which were American. Despite the difficulty in spotting aircraft underwater, the team used the story of an airplane gunner to locate them amid the coral and debris. The discovery highlights the historical value of underwater exploration and the role it plays in uncovering lost artifacts and events of the past. That's all for this video. To ensure that you don't miss any of our new videos, please like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Until next time, take care.
Thanks for watching.